Welcome to Blues Weekly, brought to you by Scott Credit Union. I'm Brooke Grimsley. After 11 days off for the All-Star break, the Blues starting the second half of the season with back-to-back games at home. After a demoralizing 7-4 loss to the Devils, the Blues were able to rebound quickly with a win against their rivals, the Chicago Blackhawks, last night. Let's take a look back at the bounce-back win. The Blues get off to a fast start in this one. Blues on the power play here, and David Perron fires one right at Marc-Andre Fleury. The Blues strike first. It's 1-0. Blues. Still in the first period, Torrey Krug unloads right towards the net. Dakota Joshua is there for the rebound and tucks it home on the backhand to double the Blues lead. Under a minute to go in the second period, it's a 2-1 game now. Watch this. Robert Thomas here between the legs, dish to Vladimir Tarasenko, who rips home the feed. It is 3-1 Blues now. The Blues making sure to add some insurance this time in the third period. Nico Mikkola fires a shot off the boards, and Oscar Sundquist puts the rebound into the back of the net. It is 4-1 Blues now. Jordan Kyrou adds to the lead. A little spin move right here and rips one home. The Blues take down the Blackhawks, winning 5-1. Vladimir Tarasenko and his little one stealing the show in the postgame afterwards.
Our game trusts our structure, and give us wins. And you don't need to be smart to understand this. If you just follow the plan and everybody play for each other, you will be able to win games. And there's a hope to win a cup. So only the team game can bring us this.
We had a real good forecheck in the second period there. You know, that was a big goal by Tarasenko off of a forecheck. And I thought the Dakota line there had a good shift there in the first on a forecheck, and then a good net front with a goal. I thought Barbashev was real good in a forecheck tonight. He was physical, took the body on the forecheck, so it was good to see.
For more insight on the Blues, we bring in now voice of the Blues for Bally Sports Midwest, John Kelly. John, thank you so much for joining us this Sunday. We finally got hockey back this week after a long All-Star break. Even though we would like to forget about that game on Thursday, the Blues falling flat against the Devils in their first game back, but they immediately got back on track with a 5-1 win against their rivals, the Blackhawks, last night. What did you see as a big difference between those two games, and what changed for them so quickly?
Well, it was night and day, Brooke. First of all, coming out of a 12-day break, the Blues did not have much intensity in the first period against the Devils. You know, they're down by a goal after one. And then I thought they stabilized in the second period and were leading 3-2 after two. And you're thinking, okay, here are the Blues we know and love. But then when the Devils tied the game in the third period, the Blues did not have an answer. And I think it's tough in one particular game to overcome adversity twice. And the Blues had to do that, of course, after coming from behind in the second period. And then in the third period, the Devils, of course, poured it on. They scored a couple of empty net goals. But the biggest thing from that game is the Blues had a terrible start. They were sleepy and really not up to speed in the first period. And then, of course, in the third period, after the Devils tied the game, they took over. And then Saturday night against Chicago, it was a complete 60-minute effort. I think it was the same kind of response, Brooke, that the Blues had after getting beat in Calgary a few weeks ago, 7-1. They came back and beat the Flames 5-1 on home ice. And the Blues had the same type of workmanlike effort. They had great intensity. They had two goals from the fourth line. Of course, a beautiful spinorama goal by Jordan Kyrou. And they also got great goaltending from Billy Husso in Saturday's game. So it was really night and day. But I think you have to give the Blues a bit of a break. They had not played in 12 days before the game Thursday. Meanwhile, the Devils had played Monday and Tuesday going into that game. So they were much more up to speed. They deserved the victory, but the Blues bounced back, as we said, and got a nice win Saturday against Chicago.
What a night it was for Vladimir Tarasenko. A goal, and then he handed off his stick to a young fan afterwards, and then his kids joining him in the postgame Zoom. He currently has 16 goals this season and doesn't look like he's slowing down. But more importantly, John, it's so clear to see that he looks so happy playing right now. What do you have to say about his start to the second half of the season?
Well, it obviously has been really good, and quite honestly, since the opening game of the regular season, Vladdy has been like Vladdy. He's played very well, and going into the season, and we weren't quite sure where his mind would be and how he would play, but, you know, he's been fantastic. And the goal against Chicago was a great feed, number one. First of all, Buchnevich made the play to tip it to Robert Thomas. He makes that no-look pass between his legs. Vladdy buries it and makes it 3-1. And then I know Darren Pang told me after the game that those fans were really excited to meet somebody, and for Vladdy to come over after his interview with Darren to give him a stick. Well, he just made their night. And of course, Vladdy had his kids at the podium afterwards. And, you know, he's a great family man. And it's good to see. It's good to see, to me, the biggest thing for Vladdy, two things. Number one, that he's happy, that he loves playing here in St. Louis, and that he's playing well, because the Blues certainly need him and his goal scoring abilities.
And you already touched on it, but Ville Husso getting the start against the Blackhawks last night. He was lightly tested in the win, facing 15 of 16 shots, giving up just one goal. But he's won the last seven of his last eight starts. He just really seems to be confident right now between the pipes for the Blues.
Yeah, and I think that's the biggest difference right now between Ville Husso and Jordan Binnington. Binnington is not confident. He's not playing as a confident goaltender. Ville Husso is. And, you know, in last night's game, Chicago didn't have a ton of chances, but especially in the first period, DeBrincat and Patrick Kane both had dynamite chances, and Ville Husso came up large. Of course, the only goal scored against Husso last night came on that 5-on-3 in the second period. So Ville was sensational. There's the save again on Patty Kane. So it's great to see. He had not played in 2 weeks, don't forget. His last game was against Winnipeg on the 29th, a 4-1 loss. So he had a bit of a bounce back game. But I think, again, the biggest difference to me right now between the two goaltenders, Ville is a very confident goaltender. And unfortunately, right now, at least this moment, Jordan Binnington is not nearly as confident.
Well, Jordan Binnington, as you mentioned, they're dealing with the opposite of being lightly tested on Thursday against the Devils. He allowed 5 goals on 27 shots in the 7-4 loss. He seemed fine, but then let a 3-2 lead slip away in the second period. I know that not all of the goals were on him, John, but there were some that definitely were on him. How will the Blues really handle this goalie situation moving forward?
Well, I think that you have to go with the hot hand. And obviously, Ville Husso has the hot hand. You know, going into last night's game against Chicago, Ville Husso led the NHL in goals against and save percentage. So the numbers don't lie. I mean, he is playing really well. As far as Jordan Binnington, I think when you look back at his career in the NHL, it's his fourth year. And this is really the first time that he's faced adversity. Not that he hasn't lost games or had bad outings, but this is more of an extended period where he's faced adversity. And he's got to bounce back. But I think if anyone can, Brooke, this guy can. Because he faced adversity just getting to the National Hockey League. He really didn't become a regular until he was age 25. So I'm not, I certainly am confident that he can come back and find his game again. But to me, when you watch him play right now, he's not outside the goal crease. He's in the blue paint. You know, a backhander by VC there beats him. So he's got to get more confident, challenge the shooters a lot more. And I'm sure he will find his game at some point here.
In an interesting move this week, Tyler Bozak has been a healthy scratch for the Blues the past two games. Craig Berube saying that they decided to go with a heavier lineup with Dakota Joshua in there, and Joshua showing that he wants to stay in St. Louis with a goal last night. How will Berube and the Blues handle this situation moving forward?
Well, I think, you know, like anything, like the goaltending situation, Brooke, nothing is etched in stone. It's really day-to-day, and it's not a knock on Tyler Bozak. He has played well. But obviously, he's on the back nine of his career. And I know Berube does really like the physicality that Joshua can bring to the table. And he scored a goal again last night, his second game winner of the season. And, you know, he goes to the net. He does the right things. I think the biggest thing that I see from Dakota Joshua, aside from scoring goals, is the fact that he's always on the right side of the puck and plays a physical game. So that's the type of player that Berube likes. But again, Bozak is a seasoned veteran. And obviously, he'll get his chance again. But in the meantime, you have to really applaud the job that Joshua has done the last couple of games.
Well, right before starting the second half of the season, the Blues general manager Doug Armstrong getting busy keeping the Chief locked in for at least 3 more years. To me, and I think a lot of Blues fans, a no-brainer re-signing head coach Craig Berube through the 2024-25 season. But why did this deal get done now, and why is he the guy for this franchise?
Well, number one, he's a great coach. He won a Stanley Cup, right? Why did it take a little longer than perhaps people thought it would? I don't think there was any great urgency on either part to just sit down and hammer it out, because I don't think they were worried they wouldn't get a deal done. And that's what happened over the All-Star break. They got together, and Craig said it really came together rather quickly. And now the coach is in the fold for at least 3 more years. So it's fantastic. He's done an outstanding job for the St. Louis Blues. Obviously, his second job in the National Hockey League, coached the Flyers a few years ago before getting the job in the minor leagues with the Chicago Wolves. and has done a great job with the Blues. So it's fantastic to see for Craig and his family and for Blues organization that they have him locked in for three more years.
After two games at home, the Blues hitting the road for a three-game Canadian road trip. The Blues sitting at fourth right now in the Central Division. Every point and every win matters, especially right now as we start the second half of the season. What are you seeing from this upcoming schedule for the Blues opportunity-wise?
Well, I see a lot of road games, Brooke. Four in a row on the road and eight of the next nine games away from Enterprise Center starting Tuesday in Ottawa against the Senators. Now, the Senators won earlier today in Washington. They played very well. And prior to that, they had been shut out two consecutive games. Brady Tkachuk, of course, the son of Walt, is the captain of that team. But they're a team that's not going to make the playoffs, but they're young and fast, very hungry, coached by DJ Smith. And it's not going to be a type of game that you can go in and think, well, it's Ottawa's record's not very good. It's an easy 2 points. We know that's not the case. And then the Canadiens, a team that obviously, you know, they fire their general manager, Mark Bergevin. They just had to make a coaching change. Marty St. Louis has taken over. The Canadiens have played a little better under him, but they are still winless in the last 10 games. So that's a game Thursday night in Montreal. You've got to go in and just take care of the Canadiens. And then Saturday in Toronto, the Maple Leafs, of course, beat the Blues 6-5 a few weeks ago at Enterprise Center when they scored that late goal. Toronto obviously has a lot of high-end skill with, you know, Marner and Tavares and Austin Matthews, and the list goes on. That will be obviously the toughest game on this four-game road trip Saturday in Toronto.
All right. Thank you so much, John, for joining us, and we'll see you again, I'm sure, here next week.
Okay, Brooke, thank you for having me.
Always great hearing from John Kelly. We'll have more coming up with a new episode of the Blues Science of Hockey with Cedric the Entertainer. That's coming up after the break on Blues Weekly.